Dr. Jordan Peterson is a Canadian academic who shot to fame because he took a stand against newfangled gender pronouns. He is now a YouTube star, and his book, 12 Rules for Life, is a bestseller. Like others recently profiled in a comically apprehensive article about the intellectual dark web in the New York Times, Dr. Peterson has made a name for himself simply by making common sense observations of the kind that have become taboo. He does a great deal of good, hacking away at egalitarian foolishness, and his audience is very much the sort of people who have the potential to become race realists. However, Dr. Peterson has explicitly denounced white consciousness. At a recent talk at Lafayette College, a member of the audience asked what he thought about taking pride in European ethnic identity. He replied in part, quote, "The West has got some things right. We got the sovereignty of the individual right." And he noted that this has resulted in worldwide wealth. But then he continued, "Am I proud of that? It's like I didn't do that. What the hell? Pride? What's that?" It is odd that Dr. Peterson should ask. In the first chapter of his 12 Rules for Life, he explains that pride helps lobsters and birds guard their territory and determines which survive disease and reproduce. He also notes that self-respect helps people resist oppression. Therefore, according to his own logic, European pride is vital to the West's survival. In his lecture, Dr. Peterson said that Western civilization is a new miracle on the world stage, and that European cities are unbelievable masterpieces. He then talked about global tourists visiting these cities, implying that the cities belong to everyone, just as Western civilization does. He cautioned, however, that we have no right to take pride in European cities just because you happen to have the same skin color as some of the people there. Dr. Peterson even briefly acknowledged group differences in IQ, but he said that he is hesitant about discussing implications and then ignored them altogether. Needless to say, they have enormous consequences, and low IQ groups could not possibly have built our civilization. East Asians are the only other race with a high enough average IQ to build something approaching Western civilization, but these racial differences go beyond IQ. Asians appear to be more sensitive to criticism in a way that reinforces conformity. These differences predict a Martin Luther as opposed to a Confucius. It is therefore unlikely that East Asians would have developed the individual rights that Dr. Peterson sees as a world miracle. He then continues further, "It's not even so clear to what extent Western civilization is European. I mean, didn't it come out of the Middle East? Even if this absurd statement were true and something essential to our civilization came out of the Middle East, Europeans built our civilization, not Middle Easterners. If Dr. Peterson was talking about Christianity, it has been Europe's religion for more than 1,000 years and has received a thick overlay that is distinctly Western. Moreover, as Dr. Peterson noted, Islam, a truly Middle Eastern religion, may not be compatible with Western civilization." He then concluded on a smug note, "There we go, dispensed with the radical right-wingers in 4 minutes," adding that any racial argument is so muddle-headed that you hardly know where to start. Instead, it is his own confusion about the nature of race, Middle Eastern and European culture, and his insistence that pride must be strictly individual that are muddled. The European genome, with its effects on IQ and temperament, was necessary for the creation of our culture. As Sam Francis explained in a 1994 speech, "The civilization that whites created in Europe and America could not have developed apart from the genetic endowments of the creating people. Nor is there any reason to believe that the civilization can be successfully transmitted to other peoples. So, in a real sense, there is a we that creates things, and there is a difference between simply being proud to be white and being proud of the civilization whites created." Rather than take pride in Western civilization, Dr. Peterson says we have to get our act together and take responsibility for it. While in his book, he states that pride and caring for oneself are first steps towards improving oneself. But to discount pride in our race and heritage undermines any attempt we have to redeem the West, something that the good doctor conveniently omits.